your hair color? What's the story behind that?
I just cover up my gray hair.
To cover up your grays? But wait a minute. Christ got gray hair, brother.
Yes, Christ,
see, what you're doing is perpetuating a self-hatred. There's nothing wrong with who you are.
That's right.
Matter of fact, you don't get it. The Bible says you were made perfectly.
That's right.
In the image of your God. And your God only. Because God don't love everybody, bro.
Bring it up!
Did you hear what I just said? God does not love everybody.
That's right.
That's the doctrine that came with that image. Because they wanted to include themselves in the mix. But brother, God only loves us.
That's right.
That's what we out here to do and teach our people. God only loves the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. That's why he gave us this law. Read.
Leviticus chapter 13 and verse 30.
Verse 29.
Verse 29. If a man or woman having a plague upon the head or the beard.
Stop. Having a plague. What is a plague?
A sickness,
an illness. So the Bible says if a man has a sickness or an illness upon his head or his beard, read.
Then the priest shall see the plague.
So it's something visible that the priest can see. Read.
And behold, if it be in sight deeper than the skin,
what?
And there be in it a yellow thin hair.
A what?
A yellow thin hair.
What color is your hair?
It's like a brown mixed with reddish.
Blonde. It's blonde. It's yellow thin hair. You understand? That's
Bring
a plague.
That's right.
Read.
Then the priest shall pronounce him unclean.
Shall do what?
Pronounce him unclean.
That's an unclean hair color you have in your hair.
Right.
It's an unclean thing to look like the people that are destroying us.
Bring it up!
Because whose hair color comes out naturally like that?
Other races,
not yours.
Right, bring
the
it up!
The so-called Africans, the real Africans, the hair mites. Matter of fact, your hair color looks like that right there. Is that who you are? Matter of fact, the Bible says that's your enemy.
Proverbs 3:31. Bring it up!
That's right!
You're not supposed to look like the people that you're better than.
That's right!
That's confusion. That's self-hatred. Read.
Proverbs chapter 3 and verse 31.
Listen up.
Envy thou not the oppressor.
Read it again.
Envy thou not the oppressor.
A black man with blonde hair is envying the oppressor.
Bring it out.
You don't want to be gray. Brother, that's majestic right there. Look at that brother right there.
That's right.
That's majestic right there. Hey, my man. Excuse me, sir, real quick. You know who you look like? You look like this brother right here.
Bring it out.
You know who that is? That's Jesus the Christ, the black Messiah. You might come from the same lineage as him. Come listen to the Bible. Read that again.
Proverbs chapter 3 and verse 31.
Lord,
envy thou not the oppressor.
Don't envy the people that oppress us, that have oppressed us through Jim Crow, through slavery, through the school to prison pipeline system. You understand? Don't envy those people and want to be like them. Read.
And choose none of his ways.
Don't choose his holidays. What's coming to Halloween?
Bring it out!
Right? You celebrate. You know who do? You know people that do celebrate? We're not supposed to envy that. That's a demonic, wicked custom of another nation.
That's right.
And it was taught to you. You know why? Because the people that taught it to you, either your parents, your teachers, they envy the oppressors.
They get
free candy. Oh, they get to dress up in costumes and have fun. No, they're worshiping the devil.
That's right.
Because the only customs that can come from a demonic people are demonic customs.
That's right.
And guess what? You're supposed to be the righteous in the earth. Give me Deuteronomy 7 and 6.
Bring it up.
Let's see who you are and why you need to change your hair color as well as change your mindset.
That's right.
Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6.
As an Israelite man, that's the only way I'm going to address you from now on. I'm not going to call you a black man. I'm not going to call you African American. Those aren't what you are. You are an Israelite according to the Bible. Now let's see what God says about you, Israelite man. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6.
Come on.
For thou art a holy people.
God says we're holy. What does holy mean? Give me that. Leviticus 20, 26. Let's see what the word holy means. Because you've heard it all your life. Oh, God is holy. Holy Ghost. People, you know, we're holy people. But what does it mean according to the Bible? Read.
Leviticus chapter 20 and verse 26.
Come on.
And ye shall be holy unto me.
God is talking to his people.
Right.
They shall be holy unto him. See?
For I, the Lord, am holy.
Because we're made in his image. So in this earth, we'll be just like him. He don't have blood in his hair. Since we read in the Bible about being holy. Y'all know what holy means? What do holy mean, bro? Give me 2 minutes. Come find out. We're reading it right now. Read.
Leviticus chapter 20 and verse 26.
Read.
And ye shall be holy unto me.
Come on.
For I, the Lord, am holy.
God says he's holy, so you should be holy.
Read. And have severed you from other people.
What does it mean to be severed? Severed. What does that mean? Severed. Severed means to be cut, separated. You understand? If your arm was severed from your body, that means it's no longer attached. The Bible says you are to be no longer attached to the other people.
Bring it up!
So the hair color has to stay over there. You understand? The ideas, the philosophies of those people have to be separated from you now.
Bring it up!
And you now must become back to your heritage, which is this Bible.
That's right.
The laws in this Bible. What we read to you was a law. You understand? And why we're at the bottom of society is because we broke God's law. We're going to get that next. Read.
That ye should be mine.
Read again.
Leviticus chapter 20, verse 26. And ye shall be holy unto me, for I, the Lord, am holy, and have severed you from other people.
That's how you know he don't love everybody.
That's right.
Or else he wouldn't have separated you from them. He's telling you, don't be like them.
Bring
You're
it up.
Better than them. Be.
That ye should be mine.
That we should be whose?
That ye should be mine.
You belong to God.
That's right.
Us alone. The Chinese man does not belong to God.
That's
right. The Arab man does not belong to God.
That's
the white man does not belong to God.
That's right.
Read Deuteronomy 7 and 6.
Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6.
Read.
For thou art an holy people.
So what does holy mean?
Holy means that you are with God, meaning you righteous, you're the righteous man.
What is the word that the Bible used? It says severed, right? So what is severed?
Separate.
So what does holy mean?
Separate.
So read it again.
Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6. For thou art a holy people.
So what does holy mean?
Separate.
We're a separate people. Meaning we're not supposed to be like everybody else. You understand? Read.
Unto the Lord thy God.
Come on.
The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people.
Wait a minute. How come God loves everybody out here, but in the Bible it says we're separate?
Bring
we're
it up.
Special. So what you're learning out there, what he's taught you, is a lie.
That's right.
God only loves one nation of people.
That's right.
He only chose one nation of people.
That's right.
Me.
Unto himself, above all people.
It didn't just say above.
Above all people.
No, equal rights.
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
Not just in America.
Upon the face of the earth.
We are above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
Bring it up!
Thus saith God. I didn't write that. Did you write this? Did you write that? Did you write this? God said it. So that's who you are.
That's right.
So now, Romans 12 and 2.
Bring
Something
it
has to happen now.
Bring it up.
Something needs to change in order for you to apply this to yourself. Because, okay, God says we're above all people, right? Does this look above
Bring
our
it
people?
Up.
Our surroundings, how we live it? Do we live like we're above all people? Can we make any laws? If I said, you know what? I want to move that stop sign an inch that way. Can I do that? But I'm above all people. So what the hell happened? Read.
Romans chapter 12 and verse 2. And be not conformed to this world.
You got
to
change your mindset of who you are, of what you're supposed to be doing as a so-called black man.
Teacher, bring
on
it
the
up.
Radio, right? I hit play on the radio yesterday, like 2 days ago. I don't listen to the radio, but I hit play on it. The song, first of all, the radio station itself was having side piece shout outs. So that means you call into the radio station and you shout out the person that you're having sex with outside of the quote unquote relationship that you're in. That's this world. The Bible says don't be conformed to that.
Right,
what is it teaching you?
It's teaching me negativity.
Explain.
Like it's messing with my mind to think that's how I need to think.
That's okay.
That's right.
To have a side piece over here, a side piece over there, instead of being married. It teaches you to fornicate. So what does it do? It spreads diseases through our community.
Bring it out!
It creates baby mothers. It creates baby fathers. Single parent households raise our children up. And guess what? They become drug dealers.
Bring it out!
They become killers. They become gangsters. They become inmate number 00573.
Bring it out!
That's what's being perpetuated on our people.
Bring it out.
That's why the Bible says, be not conformed to this world. But be what?
But be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind.
Yeah, beyond your hair color changing, your mind got to change. Who you think you are and what you must be doing has to change. You have a job to do, brother.
Bring it out!
You have a calling and a purpose on your life.
That's right.
And it is to teach the commandments of God. It is to live according to the laws of God. It is eventually to rule this planet.
That's right!
That's what we're after. We're not after equality. We're after rulership.
Read. That ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
What is the will of God? Because that's what we want to know. We want to wake up and operate in the will of God, right? We don't want to be on his bad side. We don't want to be not doing what he wants us to do. So what is the will of God? Anybody over there smoking a cigarette, what's the will of God? Any of y'all waiting for the bus, what is the will of God? Sis, what's the will of God? Is the will of God to smoke cigarettes and kill yourself? Is the will of God to be hanging out on the corner, selling drugs to your brothers?
Bring it out!
What's
bring
the will
it
of
out.
God, bro?
The will of God is to be within him and to serve him and help others in a way.
To serve him, to help others. Let's simplify it. Let's see what the Bible says. Read.
Psalms chapter 40 and verse 8.
Lord,
I delight to do thy will, thy God. I delight to do thy will, oh my God.
Hey, brother, what's the will of God? Pop quiz, what's the will of God?
Will of God, don't do no evil.
Not to do no evil. Okay, that's good, but that's vague, though.
I want
to
have number one God, no other God besides him.
So you're going to what's called the laws in the Bible, right?
Yeah.
You on point. Read that poem.
Psalms chapter 40 and verse 8. I delight to do thy will, oh my God.
King David says he loves to do what God's will is, right? Read.
Yea, thy law.
Thy what?
Thy law.
Thy what?
Thy law is within my heart.
So you naming the law, that is the will of God.
That's right.
God wants you to be keeping his laws. We read a law about the brother having blonde hair in his head, right here. Right here. That goes against the laws of God. That's outside the will of God. I'm going to tell you, your daughter in pants, that goes outside the will of God. Let's read it. Because what happens if we don't keep God's laws?
You said, what about her pants?
We have to read it for you. Because this is part of us coming back to our heritage.
That's
right. You're not a so-called African-American. You're not a so-called black man. According to the Bible, if you fit those terms in America, if this happened to your forefathers, the slave trade, Jim Crow, guess what? You're an Israelite according to the Bible.
That's right!
You have a deeper history than you know.
That's right.
It's like putting a beard on your face too. We're going to get that. But first, let's deal with that. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 22 and verse 5.
Yeah.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
That's a young woman that you have there, right?
That's right.
That's a young princess. Have you ever seen princess or any other princess cartoons? Have she ever seen any princesses in jeans? Let me ask you, sister, have you ever in your cartoons or your princess movies, have you seen princesses in jeans before? Well, do they usually wear long, flowy dresses? They usually wear dresses, right? They're pretty dresses. God says that the young ladies are supposed to wear dresses. Read that again.
Deuteronomy chapter 22 and verse 5.
Come on.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
Because think about it, you and your daughter got on the same bottom. A man is supposed to wear that. That's why there's a zipper on the front. You know what? But when we use the restroom, we do what we gotta do with it, right? She has no purpose for that. That's because that item of clothing doesn't belong to her.
Read. Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
Neither shall a man wear a dress. So a woman's garment, what is that? The dress, skirt, right? So you got rappers like Young Thug, Lil Uzi,
right?
What they wearing? They wearing dresses. I seen a music video, the dude had on a wedding dress with an AK-47 nozzle in his mouth like he was giving it fellatio. That's what they want you to become. They want to effeminize you. With even the tighter pants, the cut of the pants now is getting slimmer and slimmer.
That's right.
They are feminizing us as men. Read that again.
Deuteronomy chapter 22 and verse 5. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
Princesses don't wear pants. Jeans. Denim. Y'all want to be treated as quote unquote queens, but y'all dressing like dudes. Pick one.
That's right.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
And y'all men, pull your pants up. Stop showing your behind. Act as men. Behave as real men. Y'all want to be treated like men, but you acting like boys out here.
That's right.
Man up. Read.
For all that do so are abomination unto the Lord thy God.
Because that's disgusting. A woman in pants is disgusting. How do we know? Because disgusting things start to happen to your body parts because no air is flowing through. These laws are for your good. Brother, these laws is for our benefit. You understand? Now, before I go, right? Do you have any questions about what's being brought out to you?
I understand. Y'all just asking me. Y'all asking to help me. Y'all asking to help me.
All praise to the Most High. That's the purpose of this Bible. Give me Nehemiah 8 and 8. The brother's learning his nationality. What is your nationality if somebody was to ask you?
I'm not with the white man called.
Right.
I'm who God told me.
That's right. You're an Israelite from the tribe of Judah.
That's right.
Because Africa and America, matter of fact, hold that, give me Psalms 49:11. Because those land masses were named after two so-called white men.
So on applications, you know how they got the braces and like black and Latino. So I still mark that, right? Still go by that, right?
Yes. I mean, because I'll tell you this. Right now, we don't rule the planet. Yeah. There's a bad stigma on the so-called Israelite. So if you're going for a job application and you put Israelite and they Google Israelite, and they hear the so-called white man is the devil, you think you gonna get that job? Nah, you gotta use wisdom in this captivity. That's what the Bible teaches us. Exactly. Because God gave them the art of war. So the only way to defeat the man that God gave the art of war is to use his word.
That's what?
Psalms 49, read that.
Psalms chapter 49 and verse 11.
Bring it out.
Their inward thought is that their houses shall continue forever.
So if God gifted my nation with the art of war, I'm not ever gonna be defeated. So my thing is, I'm gonna build permanent statues about myself. You guys, they came to America where millions of so-called Hispanics, Native Americans were, but that was a northern kingdom. They came here, murdered them, pushed them all into places, and then carved their faces onto the mountains. Called Mount Rushmore.
Bring it up!
If that ain't this right here, read it again.
Psalms chapter 49 and verse 11. Their inward thought is that their houses shall continue forever.
So I'm going to carve my name on the side of the mountain. Read.
And their dwelling places to all generations.
I'm going to build these skyscrapers. You understand? I'm going to make these tall monuments of my power. Read.
They call their lands after their own names.
Wait a minute. So Leo Scipio Africanus, who named Africa, what did he think?
They called their lands after their own names.
So Amerigo Vespucci that renamed America, what did he think?
They called their lands after their own names.
So you're not African American because you're not two so-called white men.
That's right.
You are an Israelite. That means prince with the power of God. From the tribe of Judah, which means God's praise.
Teach
you up. Have a deep lineage, brother.
Bring it up.
You have a royal blood running through you. You must transform your mind according to God's laws and come back to your true heritage.
Now they will see the true men of God. We are not black men, we are Israelites.
it so hard to serve God. And why would I say that I'm a Jew? It's how odd. For years I've been walking around saying that I'm a black man. I ain't saying that no more, it's how wrong, man.
This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.